Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about the functions of marketing. I am Dr. Soundara Raj. You can see a small introduction about me. At the end of the video, if you like the video, you can subscribe my channel and give a like as well. Look at the table. I have listed down the essential functions of marketing. I have identified 17 essential functions of marketing to be performed by every organization to be successful. Now let's have a look at the first function, buying and assembling. Buying is the first step in the process of marketing. It involves decisions on what to buy, what quality, how much, from whom, when, and at what price to buy the products. Assembling refers to the process of keeping the goods purchased from different places or sources at a particular place. Mobilizing all a marketer or a company has purchased at a particular place. That is what assembling. The consumers do a certain amount of assembling also. When we buy certain things for our personal requirements from different sources and assemble them together, we do assembling. Assembling is required for all kinds of products, whether they are agricultural produce, consumer products, or industrial products. The next function is selling. It is concerned with the persuasion of prospective buyers to actually complete the purchase of an article or a marketing offer. Selling is enhanced by means of personal selling, advertising, publicity, sales promotion, direct marketing, and marketing public relations as well. The third function of marketing we have identified is nothing but gathering and analyzing market information. Marketers try to understand what do the customers want to buy and when, in what quantity and at what price, etc. He also tries to understand the motive behind his purchase, that is, whether the customer is buying the product as a necessity or for style or for luxury and so on. On the basis of all this function, information and analysis, the product is designed, labeled, branded, packed and promoted, etc. Therefore, gathering and analyzing market information will take the company to the next level or to perform better than competitors. The next function is marketing planning. It involves making plans for increasing production and sales, promotion of product, etc., and also lay down a clear course of action for achieving these objectives. For example, if a product has become popular in Punjab or one of the North Indian states in India, the target of the company should be to make it popular in rest of the North India first, followed by the remaining states. This is how plans have to be made in marketing. And the next function is product designing and development. I would say this is one of the very important functions. Unless a company designs a suitable solution for the customer's problems, it is not going to be preferred by the customers. Product designing includes decisions related to the quality standards to be used for shape or design of the product, packing, etc. In order to make the product attractive to the target customers and better than the competitor's product. For example, product designing for a color television includes its shape, size, quality standard, technology, etc. The next function of marketing is standardization and grading. Standardization is a process of producing goods of predetermined standards so as to achieve the uniformity and consistency in products. This assures the buyers of the quality, price, packaging of the product. What about grading? Grading refers to a process of classifying products into different groups on the basis of their features like size, shape, quality, etc. It is mainly done in the case of agricultural products like wheat, rice, potato, etc. The next function for our discussion is packaging and labeling. Packaging means it's a process of designing and preparing the package for the product, while labeling is concerned with putting label on the package. Packaging and labeling have been recognized as pillars of marketing. They not only provide protection to the products, but also act as a promotional tool. Sometimes the customers assess the quality of the product from its packaging. Packaging has played an important role in the success of many consumer products or brands like Colgate, Taj Mahal Tea, Lay's potato wafers, etc. The next point of discussion here is branding. Brand. I told you, brand is the most important asset a company could ever own. If you separate the brand name from a company, I am sure the company has to start from scratch. That is what the importance of branding. Branding is a process of giving a brand name, a symbol, a logo to a product to differentiate from competitors' products, and in buying, building customers' loyalty, and in promoting the product. The most important decision under this strategy is whether to give a separate brand name or the same brand to all the products of a business firm, like the one what we find with LG, Philips, and so on. The next point here is customer support services. The key to marketing success is the satisfaction of customers. All the activities of marketing rotate around only one person, is none other than customer. Therefore, an important function of marketing, it is the customer support services. It is to provide various support services like after sales service, procuring credit services, handling customer complaints, consumer information, etc. These services help in getting, keeping, and growing the number of customers. The next point is pricing of products. Unless a market offer is appropriately priced, I don't say it is priced as low as possible or as high as possible. It has to be appropriately priced, keeping in mind the perceived value of the customers over the products. It is nothing but the amount of money which a customer is required to pay for purchasing the product. Pricing has a great effect on the demand for the product. A little variation might be up or down in price may increase the demand or decrease the demand, and it will definitely not perform better than that of competitors. So price has to be appropriately fixed for the marketing offers of a company so that the products are going to perform much better than that of the competing brands. Thus, I would say, while determining the price for a product, various factors like types of the customers, what for they buy the product, their income, the firm's objective, the product demand and competitors policy, etc., should be considered. The next point of discussion here is promotion. Promotion of product and services refers to providing information to the customers, the target customers, about the firm's products, their features, their uses, their ingredients, their prices, etc. And also persuading them to buy the products. Advertising, personal selling, publicity, and sales promotion are the main tools of promotion. A marketer has to decide about the promotion budget, the promotion mix. That's nothing but combination of the promotional tools he is going to follow for promoting his market offerings. The next point of discussion here is physical distribution. The decision areas under this involves selection of channel of distribution, transportation, inventory levels, storage, and warehousing. This is an important function which fills the gap between the point of production and the point of consumption. The next point of discussion here is transportation. Transportation means physical movement of goods from the place of production to the place of consumption. I'm sure I can share with you a good example regarding Maruti cars that are manufactured in a state in North India, but that are made available all over the country. Not only the finished goods are to be transported, but also the raw materials need to be transported. Transportation gives place utility to the products. The next point of discussion here is storage or warehousing. There is a time gap between production and consumption of goods. Till the goods that are produced are consumed by the end users, they have to be stored and preserved appropriately. Thus, it is an important function of marketing to provide for proper storage of such goods until they are demanded by the customers. They also facilitate regular and even supply of products throughout the country and throughout the year. This particular function offers time utility to the products. And the next point of discussion here is insurance. Insurance is a process where one party, the insurer, the company, agrees for a sum of money, which is nothing but premium, which is paid by second party, the insured, pay the insured a specified sum if he suffers a particular loss or occurrence of uncertainties. Every business is full of uncertainties and risk. So insurance is necessary for mitigation of unforeseen losses. The next point of discussion here is financing. It involves the use of capital to meet financial requirements of the intermediaries, the agencies dealing with various activities of marketing. The services are providing credit and money needed to meet the cost of getting goods into the hands of the final consumer is commonly referred to as finance function in marketing. In marketing, finances are needed for working capital and fixed capital, which may be mobilized from three important sources. One is the owner's contribution or shareholder's contribution. The second one is about bank loans and advances or long-term credits. And the third one is about trade credit, which is provided by the manufacturers to the wholesalers and by the wholesalers to the retailers. The 17th function is risk taking. Risk means loss due to some unforeseen circumstances in future. Risk bearing in marketing refers to the financial risk inherent to in the ownership of goods held for an anticipated demand, including the possible losses due to the fall in price and the losses from spoilage, depreciation, obsolescence, fire and floods, or any other loss that may occur with the passage of time. I would say, from production of goods to its selling stage, many risks are involved due to changes in the market conditions. The demand will not be as you have anticipated. There is a possibility for having change in the demand because it's greatly influenced by so many conditions that are surrounded in the market. Then natural causes and human factors could also be a matter of concern over here. Changes in fashions or interventions also cause risk. Legislative measures of the government may also cause risk. These are all the essential functions of marketing that I have identified. I hope you have understood all the 17 functions of essential functions of marketing that I have explained. Thanks for watching this video. If you like the video, you subscribe my channel.